Hi friends, this is Prabhas and you are welcome to my channel Stabilization. In this video, we will discuss about soil stabilization, why soil stabilization is used and method used for soil stabilization. Soil stabilization is the process which is used to improve the engineering properties of the soil and thus making it more suitable for the engineering use. Why soil stabilization is required? Soil stabilization is required when the soil available for construction is not suitable for the intended purpose. It includes compaction, pre-consolidation, drainage and many other such processes. It is used for many purposes. It increases different soil properties such as soil stabilization is used to reduce the permeability and compressibility of the soil mass in earth structure and to increase its shear strength. It is used to increase the bearing capacity of the foundation soils. It is used to improve the natural soil for the construction of highway and airfields. It is also used to make an area trafficable within a short period for time for emergency purposes. Soil stabilization is used to increase the unity of the soil. It helps to decrease the void ratio of the soil. Stabilization of the soil increases shear strength of the soil. Then comes to soil stabilization methods. Different soil stabilization techniques are used all over the world, such as cement stabilization, lime stabilization, chemical stabilization, bituminous stabilization, soil stabilization by gutting, geotextile stabilization, reinforced earth stabilization and electrical stabilization of clayed soil. Now comes to cement stabilization of the soil. Cement stabilization of the soil is done by mixing pulverized soil and Portland cement with the water and compacting the mix to attain the strong materials. The material obtained by mixing soil and cement is also known as soil cement. The soil cement becomes a hard and durable structure material as the cement hydrates and develops strength. Some of the advantages of the cement stabilization. It is widely available, cost is relatively low, it is highly durable. But it has some disadvantages, such as cracks may fail in soil cement, it is harmful for environment, it is requires extra labor. Then comes to lime for the soil stabilization. This process is very suitable for stabilization of muddy soils. Lime quickly improves the soil condition during construction and can add long-term improvements to the key soil properties. Adding lime can cause three major soil improvements, such as soil drying, reducing the moisture contents, soil modification, reducing soil plasticity, adding compaction and increasing yield strength. Lime stabilization increases long-term strength and reducing soil potential of the soil. Then comes to chemical stabilization of the soil. Some chemicals like calcium chloride, sodium chloride are added in the mechanical stabilization soil based on surfacing to enhance the engineering property of the soil. Now comes to soil stabilization with bitumen. Some bituminous matter like asphalt and tar are used for stabilization of the soil, generally for pavement construction. Bituminous matter when added to soil, it impacts both cohesion and reduce water absorption. Depending upon the above actions and the nature of the soil, bitumen stabilization is classified in following four types. That is, sand bitumen stabilization, soil bitumen stabilization, waterproof mechanical stabilization and oil gas stabilization. Then comes to soil stabilization by grouting. In this method, stabilizers are injected into the soil. This method is not useful for clay soil because of their low permeability. This is a costly method for soil stabilization. The grouting techniques can be classified as following, such as clay grouting, chemical grouting, chrome lignin grouting, polymer grouting and bituminous grouting. Now comes to soil stabilization by geotextile membrane. Covering the slope with a geo membrane can prevent landslide, promote growth and vegetation, divert water away from problematic area and stabilize the soil. Now comes to reinforced earth soil stabilization. In this process, the soil is constructed with artificial reinforcing. The main advantages of this process is it is very easy to install and very quick construction. In this process, reinforcement placed in horizontal layers throughout the height of the wall provide the tensile strength to hold the soil together. Now comes to electrical stabilization of clayed soil. Electrical stabilization of the clayed soil is done by method known as electroosmosis. This is an expensive method of soil stabilization and is mainly used for drainage of cohesive soils. If you like this video, please like and subscribe this channel. If you have any doubt or any suggestion, you can comment us. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.